Assalamualaikum, hi everyone. So for today's video, we are going to learn probability lecture 3 of 3 part 1. Okay, the learning outcomes for this video is at the end of this topic, students should be able to solve conditional probability, and then students should be able to identify and apply the conditional probability formula, which is probability of A given B equal to probability of A intersect B divided by PB. Okay, conditional probability is the probability that an event will occur given that another event has already occurred. If A and B are two events, then the conditional probability of A given B is written as P and then A given B. So the line here noted that it is given equal to probability of A intersect B divided by PB. So PB cannot equal to 0. And probability of B given A, so equal to probability of B intersect A divided by PA. So PA cannot equal to 0. So yang dekat depan ni adalah probability that we need to find. And at the back is probability that already given or already happened. Okay, so probability of A given B is read as the probability of A given B. We also can write the formula as probability of A intersect B equal to probability of A given B times by probability of B. So we just rearrange our equation. Example 1. So, the event A and B are such that PA is equal to 1 over 4, PB is equal to 1 over 3, and PA union B is equal to 5 over 12. So, we need to find the probability of A intersect B. So, we use the additional probability rule, which is probability of A union B is equal to PA plus PB minus PA intersect B. So dalam soalan we already have PA union B which is 5 over 12 and then PA is 1 over 4 plus 1 over 3 minus PA intersect B. Okay, now we rearrange our equation and we can find the probability of A intersect B. So 5 over 12 minus 1 over 4 and minus 1 over 3. And then you will get 1 over 6. Okay, question B. The question asks for us to find the probability of B given A. So, by using the formula of conditional probability, so we have probability of B intercept A divided by probability of A. So, probability of B intersect A, we already found it from part A. Okay. So, we took from part A, which is PB intercept A is equal to PA intersect B. So, we put here 1 over 6 divided by our probability of A, which is 1 over 4. And we simplify our answer and we will get 2 over 3. Question C. For question C, so we use the formula of conditional probability as well. So probability of A intersect B divided by PB. So, from part A, we already have the probability of A intersect B. So, 1 over 6 divided by probability of B, which is 1 over 3. So simplify our answer, then we will get 1 over 2. Okay, next we want to find the probability of A intercept B bar. So the formula we have already learned in the previous video, which is probability of A minus probability of A intercept B, which is 1 over 4 minus 1 over 6 equal to 1 over 12. If you can't remember this formula, so do it manually. Now you have the event A and event B. So we want to find probability of A intercept selain daripada B. So A is this one, and selain daripada B adalah, kita loret luar daripada B. Okay, the one yang intercept, which it has two line, is our answer that we need to find. So this part, the intersection part. So to find this formula yang bahagian yellow ni, so kita akan ambil probability of A tolak probability of A intercept B. Okay, so do this one if you don't remember the formula. Okay, for question E, so we need to find the probability of A given B bar. So use the formula for conditional probability. So probability of A intercept B bar divided by probability of B bar. Okay, so the probability of A intercept B bar is 1 over 12. We already got it from question D, and then divided by probability of B bar, which is 1 minus probability of B, so 1 over 3. Then kita simplify dalam kalkulator dan kita akan dapat 1 over 8. Okay, next question. Example 2. In a college, 12% of the students are left-handed, 15% of the students wear glasses, and 3% are both left-handed and wear glasses. So we need to find the probability lah. Okay, first, before we continue to find the probability, so we need to transfer this sentence into mathematical words. Okay, so it said we need to denote our event. We name our event as L, event of student that are left-handed, and then we have the one that wear spectacles, so we put spectacle block. Wear glasses, so we put G as an event of student wearing glasses. Okay, so the probability of student is left-handed is 0.12. We convert it into the decimal, and the probability of student wear glasses, so PG, is 0.15. And 3% are both left-handed and wear glasses. So probability of L intercept G, 0.03. Okay, now, so you want to find the probability that student left-handed or wear glasses. So or means that union. So probability of L union G. So use the additional probability rule, PL plus PG minus PL intercept G. So we have 0.12 plus 0.15 minus 0.03. and then we can get 0.24. So for question B, find the probability that student is left-handed. Okay, given. So given here means that it is a conditional probability. Okay, so we need to find the probability of L given student wear glasses. Okay, so use the formula probability of L intercept G divided by PG. So we will have 0.03 divided by 0.15, and then simplify, we can get 0.2. Question C. Okay, find the probability that student is wear glasses given that student is left-handed. So this is also a conditional probability problem. So you need to find the probability of wear glasses given left-handed. So use the formula G intercept L divided by probability of L. So we can have 0.03 divided by 0.12. Then the answer is 0.25. Okay, for conditional probability, we can use tree diagram to solve the conditional probability problems. So this is the formula of conditional probability. So this is the tree diagram. So the first branch, we have the probability of A and A prime, which is the probability of A happening and probability of A not happening. So the probability kita letak dekat atas branch. Kita tulis probability atas branch. Dekat hujung ni adalah kita punya outcomes ataupun result. Okay, yang di belakang ni, when we have, we continue to do our probability. So yang atas ni adalah probability of B given A. So means that A is already happen. Okay, so kat hujung ni adalah outcomes untuk yang the second one. Okay, so A, B is the result of our tree diagram. So AB and then AB prime, we have A prime B and A prime B prime. So remember, we multiply along the branch. So these two probability we will multiply. Okay, so AB is equal to B A intercept B as well. So we will do example 3 so that we can understand tree diagram better. So a bag contain 5 white marbles and 3 red marbles. Okay, one is drawn at random and not replaced. So ada 5 white marble dan 3 red marbles dalam sebuah bag. So kita akan pilih, kita akan draw lah, kita akan draw from the bag. So then the first marble yang kita dapat tu kita tak letak semula. And then kita ambil another one. So another draw is made. Okay, by using tree diagram, find the probability of the event if both marbles are red and the marbles are not of the same color. So before we answer the probability question, we do the tree diagram first. So dekat sini kita kena identify lah kita punya event. So W is event white marble is drawn and R is event that red marble is drawn. Okay, first kita akan start. Okay, on the first draw kita akan dapat sama ada white or red. Yang ni first draw. So the probability of getting a white marble is 5 over 8. Okay, ada 5 white marbles dan total marbles kita adalah 8. And then the red marbles is 3 out of 8. Okay, so bila kita dah ambil and then kita tak letak semula. Okay, on the second draw, kita akan dapat sama ada white or red. Okay, so bila kita dah ambil satu white on the first draw, maksudnya dalam bag tu kita dah ambil white. So, tinggal lagi 4 white marbles dalam bag tu. And then total dia of course berkurang juga jadi 7. Dan red marble masih sama, 3 per dengan 7. So, tu kalau kita ambil white on the first draw. Okay, katakan the first draw tu kita dapat red. Okay, so the probability untuk the second draw. Okay, white still have 5 out of 7. So, dia akan berkurang 1 dalam bank tu. Dan red pun akan berkurang 1, iaitu awak akan ada 2 daripada 7 total yang dalam bank tu. Okay, so this is untuk second draw. And then the outcomes is, okay, sama ada kita akan dapat both white ataupun white, red, red, white dan juga red, red. And then we write the probability kat hujung ni. So probability kita akan darab along the branch, maksudnya 5 per 8 darab 4 per 7 untuk the first one. So kita akan dapat 5 per 14. Dan ulang step yang sama, darab along the branch. Untuk second one, kita akan darab 5 per 8 dan juga 3 per 7. So dapat 15 per 56. Dan seterusnya. Okay, to check whether our branch, our probability is correct or not. So the total kat hujung ni mesti dapat 1. Okay, so this is the tree diagram yang lengkap lah. Okay, next baru kita akan solve the question. Okay, so ni adalah kita punya tree diagram tadi. So sekarang kita akan jawab soalan A. Okay, so both marble are red. Maksud awak akan ada probability of R on the first marble and R on the second marble. So kalau kita tengok daripada tree diagram ni, RR adalah kat belakang sekali ni, kat bawah sekali. So our probability is 3 over 8 times 2 over 7, which is equal to 3 over 28. Okay, soalan B. So the marbles are not of the same color. So kalau kita tengok dekat outcomes, so sama ada kita akan ada white red ataupun red white. So PWR, we need to plus with RW. So 15 over 56 plus 15 over 56. And then we can get 15 over 28. Next question. So example 4. Probability Ahmad won a marathon competition is 0.8. So if he won the first competition, the probability won the first competition, the probability he won a subsequent competition is 0.7. Okay, if he lose the competition, the probability he won subsequent competition is 0.6. So subsequent tu maksudnya dia menang yang seterusnya lah. Okay, so kita start buat our tree diagram. Okay, kita let dulu W as event Ahmad won a competition and L is event Ahmad lose a competition. Okay, kalau kamu tak mau let L pun, awak boleh let W saja, and another one awak akan buat W bar lah ataupun W prime. Okay, so we start. Okay, so for the first competition, so sama ada dia akan win or lose. Okay, so dia dah bagi ayat pertama ni, probability Ahmad won a competition is 0.8. So 0.8 dekat sini. So lose dia adalah 0.2 lah. So the total branch ni mesti 1. Okay. And then for the next competition, sama ada dia akan win or lose juga. So dekat soalan tu dia kata, if he won the first competition, the probability he won a subsequent competition is 0.7. So dia dah menang sekali, dan menang yang seterusnya adalah 0.7. So L adalah 0.3. So kita ambil 1 tolak 0.7, dapatlah branch ni. Okay, dan seterusnya kalau dia lose on the first one, dia sama ada akan win or lose juga. So kita baca balik ayat dia. If he lose the competition, probability he won a subsequent competition is 0.6. So bila dia kalah and then dia menang, probability dia menang adalah 0.6. Jadi lose dia adalah 0.4. Okay, 2 for the second competition. And the third one, sama ada dia akan win or lose juga. So dia dah win dekat sini, and then dia win sekali lagi subsequent competition, so dia akan dapat 0.7. Dia punya probability 0.7. So this one 0.3. Okay, on the second one, W, he will win or lose as well. So if he lose, and then the probability he won is 0.6. So 0.6 here. Then 0.4. Okay, next. Tree diagram tak apa cantik ni. So, dia win dekat sebelum ni. So, untuk dia win, subsequent competition is 0.7. So, here should be 0.7. And then lose is 0.3. Okay, and the last branch, WL. So, they lose on the second competition. Okay, probability untuk dia win pula adalah 0.6. So, this should be 0.4. Okay, so you can has outcome. Can have outcomes. So WWW, so WWL, and then WLW, and then WLL, and the next one kita ikut dia punya branch lah. So LWL, LLW dan juga LLL. So kita ada 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And then the probability kat hujung ni. Okay, so we multiply along the branch. So the first branch is 0.8 times 0.7 times 0.7. This one. And then you can get 0.392 and do the same for another branch. So you can have 168, 0.144. 0.096, 0.084, 0.036, 0.048, and 0.032. So to check whether your branch is correct, your probability is correct, so we add up the probability, the total will be 1. Okay, so ni probability kita tadi, kita punya tree diagram. Okay, now kita nak menjawab soalan. Okay, find the probability Ahmad won 3 competition. So, maksudnya dia akan ada probability of win, win and win. So, kalau kita tengok daripada outcome, so WWW is the first one. So, the probability is 0.8 times 0.7 times 0.7. So, 0.392. Okay, for the second one, Ahmad won first and third competition. And third eh, so dia mesti dua-dua dia menang. So kita tengok dekat outcomes ni, the first letter ni adalah yang dia menang. Kita akan tengok the first letter yang dia menang lah. So kita tanda warna lain sikit. So dia mesti first and third. Ok, Okay, first and third. Okay, the win. The second one tak boleh sebab the third one dia kalah. And then win, win. Yang ni pun tak boleh sebab dia kalah kat ujung. Yang ni pun tak boleh sebab dia kalah awal-awal. So yang bawah ni semua tak boleh lah sebab semua dia kalah awal-awal. Jadi kita ada dua possibility kat sini. Pertama dan yang kedua. Okay, so kita akan ada probability of www tambah dengan probability WLW. So kita akan dapat 0.392 plus 0.144, and then you can get the answer is 0.536. Okay, so part C. What is the probability that Ahmad lose the first competition? So dia kata lose first saja. So kita tengok dekat bahagian yang awal-awal saja yang dia lose. Okay, the first one dia lose, lose, lose and lose. So dia ada 4 kat sini. Jadi kita akan tambah semua probability tu. So probability of LWW tambah LWL tambah LLW dan juga tambah LLL. Jadi kita masukkanlah dia punya probability. Okay, so the total is 0.2. Okay, next example. So this one is not a tree diagram question. Okay, so 30 mathematics professors. So dekat sini dia trick kita sikit. Dia guna word dan bukannya numbers. 30 mathematics professor. Okay, out of 100 who are examined were found to be overweight. So 10 of them had high blood pressure. Only 4 of the professors who were not overweight had high blood pressure. So dia dah bagi table kat sini, kita cuma perlu lengkapkan. Okay, so 30 mathematics professor out of 100. So this is the total of sample space. So 100 is our total. And 30 mathematics professor who are examined were found to be overweight. So 30 is overweight. So bahagian overweight total is 30. So kita boleh dapat kat sini bahagian not overweight which is 70. Okay, next. 10 of them had high blood pressure. So yang overweight tadi, 10 of them has high blood pressure. So dekat bahagian sini. So 10. So sini kita akan dapat 20. Okay, next. Only 4 of the professors who were not overweight had high blood pressure. So not overweight had high blood pressure. So dekat bahagian sini. Only 4. So 4 here. So kita tolak, kita akan dapat 66. Dan yang kat hujung ni kita total, kita tambahlah. So 86. So bila nak buat table, you kena identify yang mana dulu yang you kena isi. Okay. So kita akan menjawab soalan sekarang. Okay, find the probability that a mathematics professor have high blood pressure and overweight. So A is probability of H intercept W. So kalau kita tengok daripada kita punya table, H intercept W is 10. So the probability should be 10 over our total is 100. So 0.1. Okay, soalan B. Probability professor have high blood pressure given that he is overweight. So given maksudnya soalan conditional probability. So probability of high blood pressure given he is overweight. Overweight, oh sorry, dia guna W. So use the formula probability of H intercept W divided by probability of W. So H intercept W is from the first part 0.1 divided by probability of overweight, which is 30/100. So simplify our answer, we can get 1/3. And question C, find the probability professor will not have high blood pressure if he is overweight. So given here if. So if ni adalah another keyword yang menunjukkan dia adalah conditional probability. So macam mana kita nak tulis dia? Dia minta probability of professor will not have high blood pressure. So not have means that H bar lah. Given if he is not overweight. Not overweight, W bar. Okay. So we masukkan dalam formula probability of H bar intercept W bar divided by PW bar. Okay, so H bar intercept W bar. So dalam table adalah 66. So 66/100 divided by, so W bar is 70/100. Okay, then simplify, you akan dapat 33/35. Okay, note here. Okay, awak tak boleh tulis dekat sini. So katakan dia kata H bar intercept W bar. So you just write it as 66 and then divided by W bar, which is 70. And then you still can get the same answer, but this is wrong because 66 is not a probability. It is just a number. So probability should be between 0 and 1. So you need to write it as 66/100. Okay, so that's all for this video. So we will continue for the next video. So thank you for listening.